Hello dear children, today we are going to solve the word problem based on measurement of length. So let's see exercise 46. First sum, a rope is cut into two pieces of a length 5 meter 36 centimeter and 4 meter 79 centimeters respectively. What was the original length of the rope? Children, here we have given one of the rope and it is cut into two pieces and length of each piece is given to us. By using this length, we have to find out what was the original length of the rope. So let's solve the sum. First, we'll write the solution. Length of a first piece, that is 5 meter 36 centimeter, and length of second piece, it is 4 meter and 79 centimeter. We have asked to find out what was the original length of the rope. So to find out this, we need to add both of the lengths in one another. We'll add the centimeters first. See here, 6 plus 9, it is 15. We'll write 5, carry over 1 to the next place. 7 plus 3, 10 plus 1, 11. We'll write 1 and carry over 1 in meters column now. Okay, then we'll add the meters numbers, whatever numbers are there in meters column, so that we will add. 4 plus 5, 9 plus this 1, 10. So the original length of the rope was 10 meter 15 centimeter. Finally, we will write, hence the original length of the rope was 10 meter 15 centimeter. Now next sum, a boy walks along the sides of a park. The lengths of three sides are 108 meter, then 189 meter 76 centimeter, and 235 meter 38 centimeter. What is the total distance covered by the boy in one round of the park? Okay, so let's solve by writing the solution first. Length of a first side, it is 235 meter 38 centimeter. Then length of a second side, it is 189 meter 76 centimeter. And length of a third side is 108 meter and 0 centimeter. Now to find out what is the total distance covered by the boy in one round. So here we'll add all the lengths of the three sides of the park. So let's write a sign of a addition here. And now we will add the numbers in the centimeters first. So let's see the numbers at the ones place in centimeter column. 0 plus 6, 6. 6 plus 8, 14. We'll write 4, carry over 1 to the next place. 0 plus 7, 7. 7 plus 3, 10. Plus 1, 11. We will write 1, carry over 1 in meters column now. Our centimeters are here, we got 14 centimeters. Now let's add the digits in the meters column. 8 plus 9, 17. 17 plus 5, 22 plus 1, 23. We'll write 3, carry over 1 to the next place. 0 plus 8, 8 plus 3, 11. Plus 2, 13. We'll write 3, carry over 1 to the next place. 1 plus 1, 2. Plus 2, 4. Plus 1, 5. Means 533 meter and 14 centimeter. The total distance covered by the boy in a one round is 533 centimeter, meter and 14 centimeter. Finally, we will write, hence the total distance covered by the boy in one round is 533 meter 14 centimeter. Next sum. How is 9 meter 67 centimeter less than 20 meters? See children, if you read the sum, you will come to know. You have asked how much 9 meter 67 centimeter is less than 20 meters. Okay, so to find out this, we need to subtract. Okay, this 9 meter 67 centimeter from 20 meters, because if we'll compare 9 meters and 20 meters. What is the larger sling? Yeah, it is 20 meters. So from this 20 meters, we will subtract 9 meters, 67 centimeters. So let's write by arranging the lengths in a proper columns, means in meter and centimeter. So 20 meters, 00 centimeter minus 9 meter, 67 centimeter. Let's subtract. First centimeter we will subtract. 0 minus 7 is possible? No. So we will borrow 1 from the next digit. This next digit also 0. So to convert this 0 into 10, we'll borrow again 1 from the next digit. If we look in the meters, here also 0 is there. So to convert this 0 into 10, we'll borrow 1 from the next digit. So this 2 gave here 1. What will remain with 2? 1. Now, this 10 gave here 1. What will remain with this 10? 9. With this 10 gave here 1. So what will remain with this 10? 9. Again, here this 10 gave here 1. What will remain with this 10? 9. Okay, now we can subtract the numbers. 10 minus 7? 3. 9 minus 6? 3. 9 minus 9? 0. And 1 minus 0? 1. So, 9 meter 67 centimeter is less than 20 meters by 10 meters 33 centimeter. Okay, now the next odd number sum. A pole 8 meters 75 centimeter long was put in a pond to measure its depth. If 4 meter 88 centimeter of the pole remains outside water, what is the depth of the pond? Okay, so to find this out, we need to subtract, okay, the length of the pole is given to us. From this, we will subtract what length of the pole after putting inside the pond, the length of the pole remain outside of the water, that we will subtract. So let's see, we will write the solution. Total length of a pole, it is 8 meter 75 centimeter. Then the length of the pole that remains outside of the pond, it is also given in the sum, 4 meter 88 centimeter. After subtracting this 4 meter 88 centimeter from 8 meter 75 centimeter, we'll come to know that what was the depth of the pond. Okay, so let's subtract the centimeters. 5 minus 8 won't be possible, so we will borrow 1 from the next digit. 7 gave here 1, 6 will remain with 7. 6 minus 8 won't be possible, so we'll convert this 6 into 16 by borrowing 1 from the next digit. So in meters, whatever digit is there, this 8 gave here 1. So what will remain with 8? 7. Now, let's subtract. 15 minus 8, it is 7. 16 minus 8, it is 8. Our centimeters we got here, 87. Now let's subtract the meters. 7 minus 4, 3. So, the depth of the pond, whatever we got, is 3 meter 87 centimeter. Finally, we will write, hence the depth of the pond is 3 meter 87 centimeter. Next sum. A tree was 7 meter 10 centimeter high. The upper part of the tree is broken by the wind. If the remaining height of the tree is 4 meter 78 centimeter, what length of the tree is broken by the wind? Children, we have given the total length of the tree, 7 meter 10 centimeter, and some of the part of the tree is broken down. Okay, means the upper part of the tree is broken down by the wind. And whatever part of the tree is remain, its height is given to us. It is 4 meter 78 centimeter. So we have to find out what is the length of the tree is broken by the wind. So let's write the solution. Total length of the tree is 7 meter 10 centimeter, and length of the tree that is remain, okay, it is not broken. So the height we have given, the length it is remain 4 meter 78 centimeter. Now after subtracting this 4 meter 78 centimeter from 7 meter 10 centimeters, we'll come to know that what length of the tree is broken by the wind. So let's subtract the centimeters. 0 minus 8 won't be possible, so we will borrow 1 from the next digit. 1 gave here 1, what will remain with this one? 0. 0 minus 7 won't be possible, so we'll again borrow 1 from the next digit. 7 gave here 1, what will remain with 7? 6. Okay, now we can easily subtract the numbers here. 10 minus 8, 2. 10 minus 7, 3. Centimeters, we got the difference, it is 32 centimeter. Now let's move on the meters. 6 minus 4, 2. So the length of the tree that is broken by the wind is 2 meter 32 centimeter. Next sum. A shopkeeper had a bale of a cloth 65 meters long. He sold 18 meter 75 centimeter to one customer, then 16 meter 45 centimeter to another customer, and 9 meters 85 centimeter to a third customer. What is, means what length of a cloth did he sell in all, and what length of a cloth is left? See children, in this sum we have to do two operations together. Okay, first of all we have to find out what length of a cloth is sold by the customer to the respective, what length of a cloth is sold by the shopkeeper to the respective customers. So to find it out, we need to add the length of a cloth. So let's see, we will add that first. Length of a cloth that is sold to first customer is 18 meter 75 centimeter. Then length of a cloth sold to second customer is 16 meter 45 centimeter, and the last length of a cloth that is sold to third customer is 9 meter 85 centimeter. So let's add the centimeter first. 5 plus 5, 10 plus 5, 15. We'll write 5, carry your 1 to the next place. 8 plus 4, 12 plus 7, 19 plus 1, 20. So we will write 0, carry your 2 to the next place. Now here our centimeters calculation is over. Now let's add the meters. 9 plus 6, 15 plus 8, 23 plus 2, 25. So we will write 5, carry over 2 to the next place. 0 plus 1, 1 plus 1, 2 plus 2, 4. It is 45. So the length of a cloth sold to the three customers is 45 meter and 5 centimeter. Now children, this shopkeeper have 65 meter cloths with him. Okay, and he sold 45 meter 5 centimeter cloth to 3 customers. Now we have to find out what length of a cloth is left. So to find this, the leftover length of a cloth, we need to subtract from the total length of the cloth the shopkeeper had. It is 65 meter 00 centimeter. From this we will subtract the length of a cloth sold to the three customers, that is 45 meter 5 centimeter. So we will subtract this 45 meter 5 centimeter. Let's subtract now. Look at the digits at the centimeters. 0 minus 5 is possible? No. So we will borrow 1 from the next digit. Here also 0. So to convert this 0 into 10, we'll borrow 1 from the next digit. So this 5 gave here 1. What will remain with 5? 4. Okay. Now this 10 gave here 1. What will remain with this 10? 9. Now 4 minus 5 won't be possible, so we'll again borrow 1 from the next digit. 6 gave here 1. What will remain with 6? 5. Now let's subtract. 10 minus 5, 5. 9 minus 0, 9. Here difference we got 95. Now 14 minus 5, 9. And 5 minus 4, 1. So 19 meter and 95 centimeter cloth is left with the shopkeeper after selling the cloth to 3 customers. Okay, next one. One day, Mr. Ganeshan hired a taxi. He traveled 15 kilometer, 275 meter from his residence to his office. 8 kilometer, 685 meter from his office to his friend's house. And 10 kilometer, 50 meter from his place to residence. What is the total distance traveled by him on taxi? So to find this whatever distance, total distance covered or traveled by Mr. Ganeshan on taxi, we need to add all the distance. Okay, so let's see, distance traveled by Mr. Ganeshan from his residence to his office, that is 15 kilometer, 275 meter. Then the distance traveled from his office to friend's home is 10 kilometer, 50 meter. And distance traveled by Mr. Ganeshan from his office, okay, to his friend's house is 8 kilometer 685 centimeter. So now we will add the meters first. 5 plus 0, 5 plus 5, 10. So we will write 0, carry over 1 to the next place. 5 plus 8, 13 plus 7, 20 plus 1, 21. We'll write 1, carry over 2 to the next place. 6 plus 0, 6 plus 2, 8 plus 2, 10. We'll write 0, carry over 1 to the next place. Now let's see, 8 plus 0, 0 plus 5, 13 plus 1, 14. So we will write 4, carry over 1 to the next place. 0 plus 1, 1 plus 1, 2 plus 1, 3, 34. Okay, so the total distance traveled by Mr. Ganeshan on taxi is 34 kilometer, 10 meter. Okay, so children, here we have completed the word problems from unit 12, measurement of length. Okay, sorry, unit 11, measurement of length.